What's the crack?
What's the bleeding story? How are you all doing? Hope you are having a good Friday, had a good day, weekend. Hope you're off. If you're not off, enjoy work. Stay safe, everything like that. We're just sort of doing a quick video here. Well, it mightn't be quick, I don't know. We'll see, we'll just roll with it. Just about Arteta's press conference. What do you think of his top? He was talking about it earlier on.
Lovely.
Do you like his drip? Arteta milling the drip out of it, looking bleeding fresh, fresh. And it's, you know what, it freaks me out that this stuff is lovely, because I really want to buy. I actually do like it as well. Zach pointed it out, and it's just, you know, what did you think?
It's really nice, actually,
yeah. Yeah, but look, I don't like supporting the merch and stuff like that, like, you know, but there's only so much, especially when you have a young fella, you know, and he's at you all the time. Buy me this, buy me that, you know. So we'll see. Excuse me. We'll see how we get on. So look, we're just going to talk about the press conference today, Arteta's press conference, and I'm just sort of took a few notes down and stuff like that of what he said, and just basically, like, you know, he was jumping around a few questions here and there, and it's just my take of what he was talking about. The first, and like this, you know, with the journals, like, oh, I just get frustrated, you know. I won't even, like, one question here. How are you feeling after COVID? Like, what's he going to say? I'm actually dying. I shouldn't be here. I want to go home. Please, send me home.
Send me home, please.
You know, seriously. Like, 9-year-old is laughing at you, mate. So whoever asked that question, a 9-year-old's laughing at you, all right? And you went to college, and I'm sure you went through all that sort of malarkey. And you're asking a question like that. Well, in Dublin, there's a 9-year-old laughing at you. You have a pass to go to a press conference and you ask him, how are you feeling after COVID? Stop, we'll continue. How are you feeling after the City game? Okay, well, how are you feeling but after the City game? Oh, I done somersaults around my living room. I was so delighted. Like, he didn't say that clearly. Jesus Christ, what the fuck do you think he's going to say? Sorry. Beep. Like, what are they thinking he's going to say, you know? He basically says, proud of the players, supporters are great. Yeah, could he say anything else? So here, someone asked another question, and fair enough, he started asking, the Xhaka fell. What did you think of that? And, like, you know, he says, the decisions from the referee was disappointing. I can't say any more or I'll get in trouble. Fair enough. And which he can't really, because, like, you know, the FA may not be Arsenal's best friend at the minute. So I suppose that's a question he sort of had to answer like that, you know. Liverpool game called off. What do you think? You know, like, you know, he's just all COVID is this and it's here. And, like, you know, Liverpool are short players and the FA obviously made the right decision or whatever. Like, you know, do you want the cup back from Leicester? Another, like, no, I don't want to win the FA Cup, no. I don't want to win the Carabao Cup, no. Don't want to win the league, no. No. Like, there's another one. Another journalist. This guy went to school, okay? This journalist. Now, he went to school, okay? He done all school, done his homework. He studied hard because he got points in his high school year, in his secondary school, to go to college. So he studied really hard for that. He got points then to go to college, and then he studied do you want to become a journalist? Okay? And he asked that question. Do you want the cup back from Leicester?
Of course you do.
This guy done, what, 3-4 years of college after that? And he asked a question like that.
That's stupid. That is
There you are again, mate. This is a different one. There's two journalists now.
Of course you want the
study. Exactly. Yeah. So there's two journalists that's in that press conference and they're asking these questions.
Like, there's... Jesus. I can do better
If you get a journalist password, just send them Zach in, right? You can ask them whatever questions you want. What's your favourite colour, Miguel? At least it's something. Do you know what I mean? At least it's something. Jesus, actually, I'm curious to know what his favourite colour is. Oh, stop. We'll continue. Like... The answer to that, he says here, we have to take each game one step at a time. Oh, like, you know, I suppose I'd say Arteta's just going, Jesus Christ. How did you get on in work today? He comes home to the wife. How did you get on in work today? There was two fucking arseholes in the press conference and he asked me two fucking stupid questions. And I'm sorry. We should cut them again.
No.
Sorry.
No, bloody asking. Oh, how much fucking daisy should you pick today?
Yeah, exactly. Stupid questions.
It's stupid. That's why I'm ridiculous. Saying curse words.
Yeah. Next question. What was it like watching your team play on TV? Yeah, all right. We hit a low point there, so
okay.
We're moving
that's
up a small
okay.
bit. It's
that's
still
not
great,
yeah.
But it's still. Someone made a choice there. His brain activated something. Anyway, you know what I mean.
Moving up.
Strange feeling, hard to communicate, but I was calm. Yeah, sure you were. You probably bleeding smashed the fucking windscreen of the car. You probably smashed the gaff window, the front room window, and now the glazer had to come the next day and bleed and replace the pane of glass. I'd say you ran amok watching that game, mate. You weren't calm. Don't give me calm. You weren't calm.
I'll be saying like 100 curse words right now.
Oh, yeah.
But I can't.
No, yeah,
I only said one.
Question. What's Arsenal's priority? Okay, fair enough. That's actually all right. I'll give whoever said that, that's fair enough. What's the priority for the season? Is it finish top four to FA Cup, Carabao Cup? What's the priority? It's not priority. It's to take each game at a time. So Arteta's just winding these lads up now because, like, you're giving stupid fucking questions. I'll give you stupid answers. So, yeah, look, he has to say that. It's a politician's answer. Oh, let's take each game at a time. I want to win every game and let's see where we are at the end of the season.
They're just there. Oh, yeah.
Oh my favourite colour is blue.
What a question
he's after giving.
Oh my god.
What an answer. Jesus Christ, do me a favour, seriously. Palace are very interested in Eddie and Nketiah. What do you make of that? He's with us and we want to keep him. We want him to stay. No. He's not up to the standard of Arsenal. He's a relegation team in the Premier League. At best, you know what I mean? Not even. I asked a Newcastle fan there the other day, would they take Eddie? No, they're just hovering above relegation. Now, I know they have the money and stuff like that, but, you know, teams down there would Burnley take him, maybe. And that's, like, you know, that's the standard he's at, you know. So, and we want to keep him. Nah, do me a favour, get rid of him, will you? What's this? Someone, here we go now. A bit of juice here. Abba's away. Do you feel right about the treatment he's been given? Arteta says, the decision I took was for the best for the club. You know, and that's fair enough. Because at the end of the day, the biggest thing is the club. It's not one player, it's the club. And until we know all the facts on what has happened and what's gone on, I don't want to, like, you know, I'm not badding Arteta or Aubameyang, because Aubameyang has done a lot. He saved Arteta's job. He's done it. Well, by just the goals he scored, like, you know, in the last few seasons, he won top goal scorer.
If he didn't do that.
Yeah, where would
Arteta
we been? Even though we finished eighth, one of the season, where would we have been? We would have been, Jesus Christ, way down. You know what I mean? So I'm not going to diss Aubameyang. I'm just going to look. I'd like to know what's going on, and I think the club should release something and say, right, this has happened, this is what we've done, and this is what's going to happen in the future. You know?
Remember,
so, fair enough.
Remember Aubameyang was my favourite player.
Yeah, well, see, there you go. Yeah, but, like, you know, the players that are there now, Smith Rowe, Saka, Martinelli, you know, they're young players, you're a young guy, and you know, it's no harm to change players. My favourite player was Ian Wright, he's just. I'm just so annoyed with Ian Wright now. As I said, he's like that scary movie. You know, the fellow on the tricycle, and he's a big fat head, and I mean, he comes cycling around. He does much scary moves. I wouldn't let him. But anyway, you guys will know what I'm talking about. You know, the little tricycle fella. I forget his name. He's in Saw or something like that, and he comes cycling out. That's Ian Wright, because Ian Wright there cycling around. New merch, get the new merch. Fuck off, Ian Wright. Seriously, you're doing me bleeding head in. And I'm such a fan of him. So anyway, hold on. I'll just continue on with this. how many COVID cases for tomorrow or niggly injuries and stuff like that, like, you know. And this was interesting. I wasn't really sure about this, or I didn't know there was many cases in Arsenal. And he goes, I cannot say any more for now. We are very short, but we want to play the game. So what's the story here? No one said anything about you not playing the game, mate. You know, so are Arsenal going to turn around tomorrow evening and just turn around here? We can't field the team. You know, I was just a bit weary in that his comments there that he said, I hope to God the game isn't called off. I'm dying for a game. Like, you know what I mean? I'm dying to see Arsenal play again. I'm dying to see the younger boys out playing football and see how they get on against Forest. You know, so look, we'll see. We'll see tomorrow if anything breaks around. We'll drop a video tomorrow and we'll have a chat about that. Maitland Niles went to Rome. Good question. Throw it out there. Get it out. See what happens. See what comes back. Ainsley Maitland came to me and said it's the best for him to move on, and he would like to work with Jose. He was entitled to the move as well. So and that's just me just scribbling stuff down on what he was saying. He basically did say Maitland Niles came up to him and he was like, you know, like basically Maitland Niles should have moved last season, and Arteta obviously promised him the sun, moon and stars and didn't come across to that promise. Ainsley came up to the office and says, here mate, you're fucking taking the mick out of me now. You're bleeding, you're saying that you're gonna let me give me games, you're gonna do this and you're gonna do that, and you're not fucking doing anything. I played the best game against Watford and you dropped me. Haven't been seen since. You know what I mean? No. You know, I feel sorry for Maitland Niles. I like him as a player. He's like, you know, he's the type of player that I think every club would want in their club as a squad player or as a first team player. You know, if you're a higher up team, you know, he's not a bad player to have around or to come on, you know. Go ahead.
Okay. Do you know Arteta? Yeah, Arteta. I feel like he isn't actually a coach. Do you know why? I feel like he's like a helper.
Yeah, well, do
I
you?
Actually
but,
do.
Yeah,
I feel
well,
he's like
Pep's.
He's
Pep's helper. He is Pep's helper. I'll just continue on with this. Question: does the uncertainty around three your strikers? Like, you know, Arteta just says, yeah, three players with different issues, but the players that are here are fully committed. There's a dig at Aubameyang. The players that are here, that's what he says, you know. Nothing new on the situation. So he's basically saying, like, there's no updates on any contracts or anything like that. Like, you know, or Lacazette's not improving his contract, or, like, you know, at the minute as we're speaking, you know. So, yeah, you know, we need to sort that situation out now. Get rid of Eddie, get someone in January, and get them bedded into the team this side of, like, you know, from now until May. And then that player who you have signed is ready to rock and roll at the start of the season. Now, that's just me. That's what I'd do. And that's what I'd be going to the chairman and the board and everything like that and saying that to them. This is how it works. But what would I know? I'm just a clown from Dublin. Because Ainsley Maitland-Niles is gone, will you have enough cover? Okay. We are very short at the moment, but we can't just keep a player if he wants to go. We will look to move. Yeah, so that's what he said. And your man, sort of the journalist, actually pushed him. And he said, no, we're not talking about Ainsley Maitland-Niles. We're talking about other players coming in. And he just says, we will look to move because we're very short there in that position. So he is looking for a midfielder. You know, obviously that decision to let Maitland Niles go was a bit of respect for Arsenal, that he says, look, fair is fair. You know, he deserves to play. And that's great. I admired him for that. And that, like, you know, I don't want to see a player like that rot, i.e. Pepe, you know. But yeah, look, he's saying that they are short. So let's hope that there is something done in January, be it a loan move or something. And Gigi Wijnaldum, that's who I'd like there. But we'll see. Emil Smith-Rowe, will he get a chance at Forest? He hasn't been playing of late, starting of late. And he said he wasn't 100% fit, and the other players playing were in better form as well. So it was hard to, like, you know, just throw him in there as he wasn't 100% fit. that's fair enough. You know, you don't want him getting injured, and hopefully he's back to full health now and he can kick on for the rest of the season and, you know, do good for us. A pundit says that Saka is world class, and he just says, I don't like painting, putting pressure on the player like that, like, you know, so yeah, whatever he was saying. And the journalist then says, will big clubs come after him? And he just says, it's good when other clubs talk about the players because you know they're doing good. And he says, will you be looking to sign him, give him a new contract? And he just goes, there's loads of time for contract talk. So no, Saka's not going to get a contract in the next few months anyway. Maybe in the summer they might tie him down and put a seriously big buyout clause in him, because I think with all our young players that we have there, like, you know, we have to tie them down to big, big contracts, because big clubs are coming. And I said it from the start of doing these videos, I says big clubs are going to be coming in for these players. We need to hold them down. If we don't, we are bum, we're gone. You know what I mean? So Zach, what do you think of that? Do you think Arteta is, you know, is he spoofing, or the journalists spoofing, or what?
I'll say both of them are spoofing.
Both. So yeah. It was a Mickey Mouse. So I'd say there's better conversations in your classroom than there is there today.
Yeah, actually, because this boy in my class, I'm not going to say his name because, you know, if he doesn't want to. But there's this boy in the class, and then he said Arsenal and Man City. Sorry, my voice. Arsenal and Man City are doing the best. I actually think that as well.
I suppose, like, you know, that's good to know. It's like, you know, tell him to support Arsenal. If you want to, you can put him on the live stream.
No,
I will tell him, Jaden. I won't say anything. I'm only messing. Now, every other team can come onto this channel and anything like that. Tomorrow, anyway, we'll drop another video tomorrow. We'll do a sort of a preview for the game, who we think is going to start and, you know, stuff like that. If it is going ahead, hopefully it is. It believe and better be. You know, we'll either drop a video or do a live stream. We'll put it into our, we'll give everyone plenty of notice if we are doing a live stream. And if we are, come join us, join in, ask a question in the comments. We can put you on live stream with us. You can have a conversation with us for a few minutes. You don't have to show your face or anything like that. No problem at all.
And
last words.
Just going to say, why did Aubameyang save Arteta?
Well, he at the time he wanted a big contract and he got the big contract, so he was playing for the contract, playing.
Why did you have to score them goals?
You're Arteta out more than me, but whatever. Enjoy your evening, everyone. Have a good Friday, a good weekend. I'm gonna have a few pints of them now, so a pint of Guinness. So yeah, have a good weekend. Anything we want to say before we go?
Subscribe
and
like and share. And
lovely. Peace out.